Good morning students, welcome back to English class. Today I am going to teach you grammar. Okay, so please view the cover page of your new grammar textbook of this year. So let's get started with the first chapter, that is sentences. So what is sentences, students? You already have studied that sentence means a group of words which gives complete sense. Okay, and there's a proper definition of sentence given here. You can see a sentence is a grammatical unit made up of a group of words that makes complete sense by itself. And you always remember, and I know you all of you know that every sentence begins with a capital letter. Okay, sentence never starts with a small letter but only capital letter, and ends with either a full stop or a question mark or an exclamation mark. Okay, and always a sentence has got subject and a predicate. So there is an exercise given here for you to do. You have to identify from the following list and whether the given sentences are either sentences or not. The first one is done. We are happy to receive you as our guest. So this is also a group of words which is giving you complete sense, therefore it is a sentence. The second one, you see, knowing completely well the consequences. So here there is jumble words, there is no proper sense. Okay, this is a group of words but not giving any proper sense, therefore it is not a sentence. Leave the blank there. In a nutshell, so here also it is only half, it is not a complete, not giving complete sense, therefore it is what? Leave it the blank, not a sentence. Then fourth, I want to join the medical rescue team. So this is the group of words which is giving you complete sense, therefore it is a sentence. And next, glad to see you. So this also is giving you complete sense, therefore it is a sentence. Next one is my flight arrived just now. So this is also sentence. Several hours behind schedule. This is also not giving any proper sense. Okay, therefore it is not a sentence. Okay, now let us move on to part of a sentence. Every sentence consists of two parts, that is the subject and the predicate. So let us see the definition. The part which names the person or thing we are talking about is called what? Subject. And the subject usually comes at the beginning of the sentence. So students, you should remember that most of the time the subject comes at the beginning of the sentence. Therefore the second part is in that case the second part of the sentence is your predicate. So what is now predicate? So the part which tells us more about the person or thing or what they do forms the predicate of a sentence. So you understood what is predicate? So part of a sentence which tells more about a person or thing, that will be a what? Predicate of a sentence. Now some examples are given here. You can see he is a subject. Okay, and laugh is a verb. So it is what? This laugh is telling about whom? He, about subject. Therefore this is a predicate. And second, the predicate may have one object too. Okay, so here I is subject and bought a book. So at times predicate may have a object too, verb and a object. Next, the predicate can also be made of a complement. Okay, so at times it can be a predicate may have complement also. Complement means appreciation. So Abhi is the name of a person. So you always understand subject means the name of a person, thing or place. That will be your subject. Okay, now predicate part will contain verb. Is, am, are, have, has, this are the helping verb. Or the main verb also it can have, like eat, go, jump. These are the main verb. So predicate always contains the helping verb or main verb. Okay, and it also has what? Object, as well as the complement, like here it is given is a musician. Abhi is a musician. So your Abhi is what? Subject and is a musician is a predicate of the sentence. Okay. Now here your work has been given to you. The question is underline the, you have to underline the subject and encircle the predicate in the sentence below. Okay. So I have done it for you. You can see and draw it in your book and understand. Okay. So the first sentence, destruction of trees is what? Your subject and causes global warming. That is your predicate. And in second, rainfall is a subject and is essential for a good harvest. It is what? Predicate. Okay, so rest of the sentence you can see and do in your book and understand. Okay. Now let us see the different types of sentences. So there are four types of sentences. They are declarative or assertive, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory sentences. So the divisions are being done here. Okay, so types of sentences you already saw here, given declarative. That means what? What is the meaning of declarative that or assertive? This means the sentence which states something or tells you or informs you about something, that is called declarative sentence. Okay, that interrogative means asking something. Now let me give you a first example of declarative statement. State something, that means what? It is first declarative sentence is divided into affirmative and negative. So affirmative or positive statement means a sentence without not, that means it is positive. And negative means a sentence which has got not, the word not, that will be called what? Negative sentence. Example has been given here, I play football. So I play football is your positive statement. And next negative is my sister does not play football. Does not. Not is here, therefore it is negative. So you understood now? Declarative or assertive sentences. Two parts, or it is of two types, that is positive and negative. Okay, so positive has always no not, the word not is not there in your positive sentence, whereas in negative you will have always not. Okay, then come to interrogative sentence. So interrogative sentence means what? Question mark. And you always should remember that interrogative sentence always ends with question mark. So there are two types of questions you can ask or that can come under interrogative. One is yes or no type question. That means example is, do you like to study English? Okay. And next WH questions. That is, which school do you go to? Or other example you can give, what is your name? Who is this? So these are your WH questions. So these are the examples of interrogative type of sentence. Okay. Now come to imperative sentence. So in imperative consists of some instructions, requests, advice or suggestions, or you can say commands. Okay. So the examples are given here. Any sentence which gives you a sense of command or request or advice, that will be coming under the type of sentence that is imperative sentence. So the example is given here for command, take down what I say. That means this is a command. So command comes under which type of sentence? Imperative sentence. Now next is request, please open the door for me. So this also comes under imperative sentence. Now next is advice, be careful while crossing the road. So this will be coming under the imperative type of sentence. Now come to exclamatory sentence. So what is this? Exclamatory sentence always expresses a strong feeling. Okay. So example is given here. How beautiful the morning. Strong feeling means a feeling of sadness or spilling of joy, or it can be the feeling of surprise. Okay. And you should always remember that exclamatory sentence always ends with exclamation mark. Okay, you can see here exclamation or exclamatory mark. So now let us move on to the exercise portion. Okay. So your first numbers section C is rearrange each set of jumbled words into a meaningful assertive sentence with proper punctuation and capitalization. Okay, so this is given to you as a homework. You have to rearrange the given words. It is jumbled. Okay, so you have to rearrange them and form proper sentence giving a meaningful sense. Okay, and section D has been done for you. You can check the see here and do it. Okay, so this is the question here is rearrange each set of jumbled words into a meaningful interrogative sentence with proper punctuation and capitalization. Okay, so here the examples are given, done for you. You can check. The first one is yesterday's watch match you did. So here also the words are jumbled. You have to rearrange and form what? Interrogative sentence. Okay. So first one, let me read it to you. Did you watch yesterday's match? Then rest you can see and do in your book. Okay, let me read it to you then. Second one is, have you lunch for will what? Okay, so this is not giving you proper sense. So what will be the question here? What will you have for lunch? And next one is, which is the tallest building? And next is, how did you make this cake? And next is, have you completed your homework? Okay, and your interrogative sentence always ends with question mark. Okay, therefore it is question mark at the end. Now let us see section E. Here what you have to do, you have to rearrange each of the set of jumbled words into a meaningful exclamatory sentence with a proper punctuation and capitalization. Okay, so here work is done for you. You can see the first one is, wow, that experience was some spine-chilling. And the next is, sunrise, what splendid A. That answer will be, what is splendid sunrise? And next one is, oh no, I made the mistake again. Okay, next is, congratulations on your achievement. Okay, it will always end with exclamatory mark. Now move on to fifth. What an amazing feast. Okay, what an amazing feast. This also will end with what? Exclamatory mark. Now let us move on to section F. So here you have to identify the kinds of sentences. Mark A for assertive sentences, I for interrogative sentences, IM for imperative sentences, and E for exclamatory sentences. In case of an assertive sentence, state whether it is an affirmative or a negative sentence. Okay, so here are the different kind of sentences given here. You have to see them and write in the box what the type of sentences in a short form. Okay, so work has been done here. You can check and do it. Not only that, you have to study, understand, and then do it. Okay, so first one is, I am very upset. I'm very upset. What is this? This is an assertive sentence. Okay, and it is assertive positive. We have already studied assertive has got two parts. One is positive or affirmative, or next one is negative. So this is assertive positive sentence. So you only have read assertive, AS. Okay, assertive sentence. The next is, please do sit down. This will be your imperative sentence because this is a request. Third one is, what can I do? This is your interrogative. Okay, fourth one, I cannot help you. This is assertive negative sentence, so you have to write only N there. Okay, the next one is imperative sentence. The next is what? Exclamatory. And next, seventh one is your imperative. Eighth is your imperative. Ninth is also your imperative sentence. And tenth is what? Interrogative. Okay. And next one is your assertive negative sentence. And next is imperative. And next is your assertive negative sentence. So you have to write N S. The next is exclamatory. Next is assertive. And all these are assertive sentences. These are not negative, therefore you have to write only A. That means assertive sentence. And last one is your what? Question. That means it is interrogative sentences. Okay, let me show it once again. Please view, understand, and do them in your book. Okay, please complete all the work in your book and study. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.